Hi, I'm Renee Ng, and welcome to In Focus California, the show where we delve into the issues that matter to you. We talk to lawmakers, community organizers, and others who shape the policies that affect your life. Today, we're going to examine a phenomenon that has claimed more than 30 lives, two of them in California, and made about 1,500 people sick. That phenomenon is vaping. E-cigarettes usually contain THC, the active ingredient in marijuana or nicotine. In fact, some say it's a healthier alternative to smoking traditional cigarettes. But evidence is mounting that it's causing severe lung disease. Even more frightening, no one is certain why. A Southern California man learned just how dangerous e-cigarettes can be the hard way.
I used to love walking with my dog every day, and now I just can't because I run out of breath.
When Gustavo Gonzalez started vaping 4 months ago, he thought he was trading cigarettes for vape pens. It turned out he got an oxygen tank instead. He's been a smoker for a decade.
I used to smoke probably like five a day. And then one day I went to the gas station and they had this special jewel pot thing that I tried for the first time, and I like it. I like the flavor.
Gonzalez says after vaping nicotine for about a month, a coworker told him about vaping THC, the chemical that gets you high.
I liked it because I had the same feeling, but it was odorless, so there was no smell.
Gonzalez says he was eventually vaping one cartridge of THC per day, the equivalent of 1 gram of THC. He says it was getting expensive, so he started looking on apps like OfferUp and websites like Craigslist for cheaper options.
They had the same type of cartridges for half of the price that I was paying.
Gonzalez says he would pay up to $60 for a cartridge in a smoke shop, but found them online for as little as $15.
The packages are the same, even with the same seals.
Gonzalez says he vaped for months with no problems. But one day, everything changed.
I started feeling a fever. Then I had diarrhea the same day. And then the next day, I feel worse. Monday, Tuesday. Then Wednesday, I was feeling terrible. And a good friend of mine took me to the hospital right away.
When Gonzalez got to LA County USC Medical Center, doctors said he had pneumonia. What's more, doctors found a buildup of oils inside his lungs.
They told me it was very compared to a commercial kitchen where they cook every day and they don't clean up the filters. All the grease stays there, and that's basically what happens inside the lungs.
Dr. Richard Castriotta is Gonzalez's pulmonologist.
In this case, a toxic substance inhaled directly into the lungs with the e-cigarette tripped off a defensive mechanism from the lungs that resulted in basically drowning in your own secretions.
Castriotta says the likely culprit was the cartridges Gonzalez found online and put into his vape pen.
Some of the things sold under the general heading of cannabis derivatives seem to be implicated in many of these vaping incidents.
As for Gonzalez, he says he doesn't blame the online seller. He blames himself and feels bad that now his family is paying the price.
I feel really guilty. Guilty because I knew I was not gonna be able to work and support my family.
Juul, the largest and best known e-cigarette company, announced just days ago it's suspending the sale of its fruit flavored products in the US. It will no longer sell its mango, cream, fruit, and cucumber varieties online. The company had halted sales in retail stores last year. Experts say fruit flavors are particularly attractive to kids. One final note, the parent company of Philip Morris owns a 35% stake in Juul. Still ahead, we talked to Los Angeles City Attorney Mike Feuer about what he's doing to keep e-cigarettes out of the hands of kids, including a new education campaign.